basically, you just met with the governor. What are Sunova's plans for Puerto Rico? How do you see yourself helping, you know, the island restore its power grid? I know that you work with renewable energy, but can you maybe talk to me about what happened with the governor?
Sure. I think, you know, first, there's the short-term pain and issues. So how do we get the power back on?
Right.
And, you know, that we have 10,000 customers on the island, obviously want more, and we certainly have the ability to go and do that now. Now, all of our customers had solar only, okay, and that was interconnected with PREPA, the grid. Okay. And so when the grid goes down, those customers go down. Now, the power is still being generated by the panels, and you've got to switch the equipment out with batteries.
Oh.
Batteries. And then batteries enable you to run without the grid.
Okay.
And so that's what we're doing right now. So as soon as Maria, actually right before Maria hit, we started calling all around the world, around the globe, looking for batteries and then directing them into Puerto Rico.
Okay.
So we will expect our first shipment here in the next hour.
Okay.
And then we're rolling those out as fast as we can, and we have other shipments coming. Okay. So that we can start to get power to people's homes all across the island.
Okay, where are you essentially offering service right now? I know it's not island-wide, right?
We're trying to get up island-wide,
yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, in fact, what we're trying to do is figure out exactly what homes will be the last to come up so we can prioritize them first.
Okay.
You know, I guess the last should be first, the first should be, yeah.
Sure.
So, you know, that makes sense, I think, to most people. But then also there's just a huge demand. Everybody recognizes that, you know, the grid is not good enough in the sense, you know, especially in crises like this. I live in Houston, okay,
mm-hmm.
So I have backup
Harvey.
Power. Yes,
uh-huh.
I got hit by Harvey and lived through that. But, you know, you need to have more than just the grid. I don't care where you are. And that's my point. Whether you were in San Juan or whether you were in Houston, it's or even in Miami, right? You need to have more of a steady, more resilient power service. And that comes in the form of Sunova service.
So what's going on with the government?
Well, I think, one, it's in the short term, but also the long term. And again, you want a more steady, resilient service. And the people of Puerto Rico deserve that. Governor feels very passionate about it. Both, you know, obviously taking care of the near-term pain and getting people the power on in their homes so they can live.
Right.
And then the long-term side is how do we do better than what we came
mm-hmm.
in here?
Mm-hmm.
How do we have a better future?
Sure.
How does Puerto Rico lead the world in the new energy industry? And that's what's happening right now.
But
that's what I shared with the governor, and he was quite excited about that.
How open is PREPA to doing this? Because the belief out there is that PREPA is closed to, you know, any kind of renewable energy or, you know, any kind of progress.
I think that, you know, look, there are issues there, and change is hard. I know that. But, you know, the executive director, Ricardo Ramos, has said repeatedly that he wants things to change. He understands things have to change and likes what Sunova's done for the island and what solar can do, and batteries in particular combined with solar and for Puerto Ricans. And so I think he'll show leadership there and lead us into the new future. And really, it's about, you know, taking care of Puerto Ricans now and in the future, and I know he wants that legacy, and so I'm sure Mr. Ramos is going to give that.
How expensive is it, and who would cover the cost of, you know?
Well, we raise all the capital.
Okay.
So we have that coming from Sunova. We pay for all the equipment up front, and then we sell the power batteries, you know, that service to our customers, and they pay per month, just
okay,
like
okay, just so that I understand, you have solar parks right now?
No, we have solar systems on individual homes, like 10,000.
Oh, I see. And so you would be able to, I mean, how expensive would it be, let's say, for me to go to you and say, hey, I want to hook up to, you know, Sunova system?
Zero. You pay per month,
okay.
Just like you pay PREPA,
okay.
But you pay us instead, maybe PREPA a little bit of a bill,
okay.
You know, a minimum, but you can now not only get solar, but you can get batteries as backup and combining that, and as the technology gets better and better, you are able to have a better and better service. Our logo is better service at a better price.
And so how does PREPA benefit? Because they have to have a benefit, right?
Well, the whole system needs to be redone. So you need to rethink about, you know, is this a competitive position? I don't think so. And I think that the financial issues with PREPA, right, they need capital, mm-hmm. and so that Puerto Rico needs capital. And their PREP was very interested in Puerto Rico, obviously, an integral part of the community. And so looking ahead and being a part of, and being a good steward and a good leader of the community, saying, you know what, we got to change. The technology has changed, specifically with solar and batteries, and having outside capital come in and invest in Puerto Rico. We always need that. That's what my company has done. More so than anybody else in the energy space in the last 5 years, Sunnova's been there. So that combination could be a partnership between PREPA and Sunnova, mm-hmm. not a competition. Mm-hmm. And that's what's best for Puerto Rico.
So what's next? What do you need to do? What do you need from Puerto Rico to be able to grow? I mean, what's next?
Yes. Well, first of all, we're going to come back bigger and better than ever. And we're going to lead the world here in Puerto Rico. And I firmly believe in Puerto Rico. I've come here. We've been here since, almost 5 years ago. We're here constantly, all the time. We've got an office here. We are embedded in the community. We want to see Puerto Rico succeed more than anything else. And I know that's going to happen because I believe in the people of Puerto Rico.
Okay.
So what we need is to cut some red tape and get some things moving faster. And the governor committed to that. He said, yes, I agree with that too. I said, getting people the power on in their homes now, not later. Absolutely a goal of the governor's, and he's going to go out
there.
We've
been without power for 20 days, at least many of us have.
Yes, and it's going to take a while, so he knows that, but and there are just some physical limitations, but getting some of the red tape out of the way and so forth, that absolutely can be done, and I know he's going to do it, as well as others within the government, so that we can get the power on as soon as possible, and it's going to be different for everybody, and that is the unfortunate fact and reality, but
now,
getting through that and getting to the other side is as quick as possible.
Have you set any kind of milestones, any timeline at all, as to when you would want to be, and where?
Well, we'll start having our first customers with batteries in the next few days.
Okay.
Look, it's a very fluid situation. So for me to give you a commitment and say by this, that's what I'm asking of my folks, to be candid. We don't know enough information just yet, and we're trying to get an assessment for instance, what areas, what neighborhoods are going to come up first, what neighborhoods are going to come up last, and so forth, and be able to try to prioritize things. I think over the next few days, we'll have a lot better information, and we'll be able to start scheduling out shipments of batteries and other equipment. We have a lot of equipment on the island in terms of solar panels and inverters that we kept, and we pre-positioned before the storm, along with our local partners and dealers who, we are really key in making us a success as a company, and they have a lot of people here. Their jobs are going to be created, lots and lots of jobs, and more people are going to need to come back from Texas and Florida and to come work here in Puerto Rico and rebuild Puerto Rico, and that's critical. What we can do here is not only turn the lights on short term and then have a longer term future, but we can bring hope and we can bring confidence in Puerto Rico, and that's the most important thing.
What's your customer profile here? Is it mostly businesses, or do you, is
all
it
homes?
All homes. Okay.
Yes.
Are your plans, during this visit, are you going to go to the ravaged towns like in the center of the island, and just to get an idea of what, if anything, you can do there? Because I think that's probably the most critical aspect right now.
We've already had our teams going in all areas. In fact, by the next 48, 72 hours, we'll have a representative where we've been into every part of the island to know kind of what the kind of damage was done.
Okay.
And I will tell you this, the damage to the solar systems, a lot of people said, oh, it's all gone and everything else. That's absolutely not true.
Okay.
It looks like that we did very well compared to the worst fears, and certainly I had them too as Maria was bearing down on us. But it looks like that for the most part, we've done, the systems have come through very well.
Okay.
So we're going to replace. We're working hard to do that as fast as possible. And then, like I said, in addition, adding batteries as fast as possible to those customers where they want the batteries or they need the batteries and so forth.
Okay, so I guess it's up to, the government to open the way, right?
Open a little way and we'll take the rest. I think really it's all about harnessing the power and the passion of the people of Puerto Rico to rebuild and rebuild even better than before. And that's fantastic. We need to make sure that we can go out there again, pull everybody back, you know, from the States and say, look, this is not only a future for Puerto Rico, it's a great future, and Puerto Rico can show the entire world what the new energy business looks like. That's going to be very valuable and very much gets to the heart of Puerto Rico as far as being a leader.
Thank you. Appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.